But then the area of the Qutub Minar and the rest of the sites. So that is the tower that is standing here, which is called the Qutub Minar. So Qutub is the name of the man who had it built, and Minar is a minaret. So that is what we'll be talking about. This is the tower which has the 379 steps all the way to the top, and it has the 5 levels which have balconies at each level. And in the top 2 floors, you find that there has been marble which has been used. So the reason why the marble has been used is because it has been restored later on in the century. So in 1478 was the last major restoration that was done on this monument. It has been struck by lightning 3 times, not just once. So please don't believe them when they say that lightning strikes only once. So, yes. And they have been working on the minaret as well. There have been times that in the last 10 years there has been work done on it. But what they have done is that they've changed the facing of the stone on the lower level, which was cracking up. And also there was water seepage going into the foundation. So that kind of made it a little wobbly. And so they have cemented it all, stopped that, contained the water, and changed the stone on the lower level of the building. So you'll see a slightly pinky color on it instead of the red sandstone. So that is the new change which has been done on it. Now we walk up closer, and on the right side you'll see another tower which was supposed to be twice the size of the original tower. But it doesn't look as if it's a newer one, it looks as if it's older. Mm-hmm. But that's because it was never finished.
दोगी बैठा हो तो दोगी बैठा हो दोगी
And you see the symmetry of the building, so it's in the same straight line. And this was done about 200 years later. Sorry, not 200, 100 years later. So this is done in 1311. That one was done in 1230 was when it was completed. It started in 1199. So it took them 31 years to actually get it done. But, it was finished. This one took about 6 years to get to this height. And it never finished after that. Because Alauddin Khilji, the man who had it built, did not have a son or a son-in-law to complete it for him. And also he was not really a very popular ruler, so the people who came after him were not very popular. So it stands in its initial phases. And you see the basic structure as to how it was done. And then the other buildings and structures that you see here, there are tombs which are lying on either side of the gardens. And we have a well, so there are in fact 2 wells that we've already seen. So this was the main source of water. You know, they had rainwater wells, they also had water tanks, you know, which were like the big huge tanks which were made in maybe like 20 feet by 20 feet deep. And step wells. So those have been found in this area as well. That particular stepwell is not in this complex, it's slightly further away from here. But again, this particular city was not very close to the river. It was almost about 18 kilometers away from the river. And in those days, 18 kilometers was a lot of distance because they had to cover it by either on foot or by horse carts or bullock carts. So eventually, all the different cities that came up moved a little closer to the river. And finally, like the 5th, 6th and 7th were on the banks, or lying on the banks of the river. Alright, so we are going to walk on inside and we are going into the mosque complex, which was originally a temple complex. So you have to take a note of, you know, the pillars which are there, which have a lot of human and animal figures carved on them. And then we have the other arch, which was the Islamic edition of the complex, so there are no human figures on that. So there you will find it is geometric pattern with floral motifs and Arabesque writing. So that is the two in the same complex. So you get to see, you know, how they have worked on what was originally there and recycled and made it to there.